Some 540 areas in the Philippines placed under a granular lockdown because of the continuing surge in COVID cases. 60 of those are in Metro Manila. Other areas under stricter COVID protocols are in Cordillera Administrative Region, Ilocos, Cagayan Valley, and Mimaropa. Interior Undersecretary Eduardo Año says more than 700 families are affected by granular lockdowns. The Philippine Labor Department issues an advisory urging employers in the private sector to extend the leave credits of employees. Availing of such benefits will allow workers to still receive salary even if they're under quarantine or isolation. But Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III says their advisory is not compulsory.
Under the policy na no work, no pay, pag hindi ka makapasok dahil naka-quarantine ka nga o naka-isolate ka, wala kang bayad. Pero under the labor code, our workers have what we call leave credit benefits. Pero kung halimbawa, naubos na, anong remedyo mo? Eh talagang wala. Talagang wala na. So hindi ka na mabibigyan ng sweldo dahil naubos yung leave credits mo. So that is the very reason nagpalabas kami ng advisory urging the employers to extend yung leave credits ng mga workers. This benefit, kung pagkasakali lang ibigay ng employer, this is in addition doon sa mga benefits nila that they can obtain either from SSS or from ECC. Employees Compensation Commission. So meron din sila mga leave credits yan.
Philippine traffic regulators will enforce stricter implementation of the no vaccine, no ride policy in Metro Manila. Starting today, authorities will also issue tickets to drivers or operators caught violating the policy. Unvaccinated passengers will also be asked to leave if they are caught riding any public utility vehicle. The Transportation Department says fully inoculated commuters accompanied by unvaccinated minors can use the public transport system as long as it is for essential travel.
Lahat po ng ating pampalubigang sasakyan po, nakasama na po dyan yung ating Ridges, yung mga aeroplano natin, yung ating mga barko, pati na rin po yung mga road transport na kung tawagin natin yung buses.
Oo, and jeep. Kasama ang mga taxi dyan?
Kasama po. Opo, pwede po silang pigilin din. Kasama po si kasi sa prangkisa nila sa under ng LTFRB. So pwede rin po silang pigilin para i-check po kung talagang bakunado po yung mga sakay nila. Ang tricycle po ay under po ng LGU. Kaya so, ordinansa po sila ng LGU.
The Philippine government will tap big pharmacies as vaccination sites in a bid to expand its booster rollout. Towards the end of the week, government will make booster shots available in select branches of several drug stores in Metro Manila. The move is aimed to help ease pressure on vaccination sites manned by local governments and the health department. After the pilot run, the program will be launched in other parts of the country.
As shown, the rollout will start first at pilot areas in NCR and then expand in other cities and lastly to other regions based on the readiness and safety inspection. Magsisimula po tayo sa January 21. Sa pitong malalaking ating pong mga pharmacist. Ipaprioritize lang po natin dito ang boosters to ensure safety sa lahat po ng priority groups from A1 to A5 and the rest of the population.
So far, some 4.7 million Filipinos have received their booster shots. The COVID-19 growth rate in the Philippines is slowing down, but the country remains at critical risk. That's the latest assessment of the health department on the current COVID-19 situation in the country. It warns it is still unknown whether cases will continue to decline or spike again. Health Secretary Francisco Duque III also blames the latest wave of infections to what he calls token compliance with health protocol.
Yung mga tinatamaan, Mr. President, either mali yung kanilang pagsuot ng mask, nakaganon, o nakalabas yung ilong. Ganon. Useless yan eh. That is what we call token compliance. But it is the wrong way of doing things. It is the wrong way of complying with our minimum public health standards.
On Monday, the Philippines recorded over 37,000 new COVID cases, pushing active infections to a new record high of nearly 291,000. As COVID-19 rips through the country, President Duterte calls it the top threat Filipinos are facing aside from terrorists. During his weekly address, Duterte said he is extremely worried over the rapid spread of infections. He hopes cases would peak soon.
The number one threat to the Filipino today, aside from itong NPA and the terrorists, is really the COVID-19 fight. It is really a debilitating sickness. There's a contagion. Contagion yan. Ito parang hawa-kihawa, mabilis. So that what keeps us worried about the, in the coming months. I just hope that the kung nag-peak na sana